In general, when you say refugee, people tend to think about someone who's vulnerable, who's looking for help, who's kind of relying on the government for help. And it's not the case. The mere fact that they came here means that they are very entrepreneurial. It requires a lot of courage to make that jump, right? And to go to a country where you don't know anything. You don't know the language. You don't have anyone waiting for you. But they are very resilient and they still make it.
This Saturday we have a thing for 200 people or 300 people.
There's a lot of hope there, so we want people to see that aspect. There's a lot of dialogue through food, and through that we want to really provide a different story where refugees are really the heroes. Eat Offbeat delivers authentic ethnic meals that are conceived, prepared and delivered by refugees in New York City. We hire refugees who are looking for a job and who are talented in home cooking. The recipes they share are really recipes that they cook for their home families. Clearly it is traditional and authentic, but not necessarily the way it was made 100 years ago. It's really the way it is made by this chef for her family. So if she's made a small adjustment because her husband is allergic to garlic, that's how we're selling it. They are supervised by our head chef and trained by our head chef, who helps them move from a home cooking scale to a more industrial scale.
So you always learn something new.
And then together we help New Yorkers discover new and off the beaten path cuisines that they wouldn't be able to find anywhere else. To really achieve our mission, we also want our food to reach as many people as we can. That's why we decided for delivery versus restaurants. When you taste someone else's food, especially when it's their home food, just by the flavors that they eat, it kind of gives you an insight into what their daily life is and what their culture is about. For us, it's really about inversing the roles. It's not us helping refugees, it's them helping us discover something new, something different, and something really delicious.
Starting a new life is difficult and challenging for anyone, and it's even more so for the refugees. They have to learn new language, they have to integrate in the society quickly, and having a job and an income helps them to be locally integrated, helps them to be self-dependent and be able to contribute to the societies that are hosting them. Once they work, you will see that they have a lot of talents and skills that they can contribute to these societies.
Eat Offbeat all started with my own search for good hummus. I come from Lebanon. I moved to New York for grad school, and I was very disappointed with hummus that I used to buy at normal grocery stores. I thought, I can't eat that. I have to make my own. Called my grandmother, got her recipe, and I started making it at home. And clearly my friends started tasting it, and they all really loved it. When I mentioned that to my brother, he said, hey, Manal, we should find a way to sell it. To see it here. Do you all have access to the agenda?
Yes.
I can have it open. So we started thinking of who could make really great hummus. That was 2013, the midst of the refugee crisis back in the Middle East. It was something that we were feeling helpless about. So it was easy to make the connection. We were entirely sure that we would find someone who's as talented as our grandmother that makes hummus for their families, that could make it for all of New York. We also wanted to discover something else. We knew there's much more to it than just the hummus. So we thought, why not make it more global and have refugees from everywhere present the dish the way they make it.
حب الطبخ لأن أول شيء يعني تعلمته من والدتي. أول ما وصلت كان شوية صعب علي. حسنت من العيشة مالتي وكون كتير مبسوطة يعني من ابني يريد شغلة أقدر يعني أشتغل وأجيب اللي هي. يعني أنا عم بطلع مرات أنا أشوف يعني الدليفري وش يأخذون الهاية من يفتحون يشوفون كتير مبسوطين زين. بس انبسط مني والواحد يقول لي واه يا سلام شو هالاكل العراقي الطيب كثير بنبسط.
It makes them really proud to see that not only are they cooking something they love, but people are loving it, and it gives them a sense of being welcome here.
Okay, awesome, nice, great.
Food is very different in every culture, in every country, but at the same time, it's really all the same. It gives you an insight into how we are all the same. We might have different flavors inside that make us all unique, but at the end, it's the same ingredients that make us all up.